Spike, I'm sure everyone knows that you have fans from all walks of life, and of course there's one very famous, very well-respected fan in particular who wanted to be here, couldn't be here, but wanted to send a message.
These are
you.
A series of clichés you've written.
that's my job this evening. Here we go, I have a letter to read out to you from His Royal Highness the Prince of Wales.
Do I kneel down for this?
I'm in enough trouble already, I'm not going to say a word.
And the Prince of Wales.
The Prince of Wales. I'm sorry I have to do this, but I know it takes a lot of the impact out of it, but here we go. As someone who grew up to the sounds of the Goon Show on the steam-driven wireless, I must confess that I've been a lifelong fan of the participants in the show, and particularly of Spike Milligan.
Oh, the little grovelling bastard.
And particularly of Spike Milligan, whose wonderfully original humour has always reduced me to helpless hysterics.
It is cripples. I know people who have been crippled in the wake of my humour. They're in hospital, crippled like this.
It is a... He loves you. Spike Milligan, ladies and gentlemen. Spike Milligan.
I should have said, call the heir to the throne a grovelling little you-know-what and get away with it, which is what you've done, I mean.
Well, I sent him a telegram the next day saying, I suppose a knighthood's out of the question.
What happened that night at the Comedy Award? I mean, you never had that in your mind to say that, surely, Spike. Or did you?
Well, I didn't know I was going to get the award. I just thought I was there dressing, and I drank two bottles of wine. I felt very good.
And, you were happy, were you, Spike?
Yeah, piss is the word. I didn't hear him say, Spike Milligan, and my wife said to me, it's you. I said, I know I'm you. And what they didn't show you was me staggering up the stairs to get the award. And what an awful looking thing it was. I'm using it as a door stopper. And they said to me, I think just they said the lifetime award. And I think I said, about bloody time. they said, there's a letter from Prince Charles. So I was well away up here by now. Then he started to say, Prince Charles says, you're very, very funny. You're a wonderful man, a very comic writer, a great comic actor, a splendid human being, one of the funniest men in the world. I can't stand much more of this. Grovelling little bastard.
Well, I think, Spike, that has blown the knighthood, hasn't it? No Sir Spike. Lord
Spike? He sent me a telegram back saying, I'm sorry that, that there's no vacancies in the New Year's honours list, he said. And it's nothing to do with me, but he said, try a little light grovelling and you might get one.
I think you should be Lord someone, don't you? Yeah. Lord someone. Who would you be? Lord Milligan of where?
Anywhere. That's it, Lord Milligan of anywhere. No, how about Lord Milligan of here?